Welcome everyone. This is Shashank Tyagi and I welcome you all to EduChemy. Today we are going to talk about collegium system. First of all, why we are talking about collegium system? Because it was in news and questions are asked in prelims as well as mains. We are going to talk about these issues. So I'm going to take you to the whole journey. Now, when it comes to this word collegium, this word actually means advisory board. Now question comes, what kind of advice this board actually give? So it gives advice with regard to appointment of Supreme Court judges, appointment as well as transfer of High Court judges. If I ask, can this dynamics of chacha vidhayak hai hamare, chacha judge hai hamare, can these kind of dynamics work in transfer and appointment in higher judiciary? When I say higher judiciary, it means High Court and Supreme Court. So I'm asking, when it comes to transfer and appointment, can this uncle judge hai hamare, can this work? So if you think that's a joke, then let me tell you, former Chief Justice of India, Mr. R.M. Lodha, made this statement. He said that Indian judiciary, especially higher judiciary he was talking about, is suffering from uncle judge syndrome. And every third judge in high courts is uncle. It means if one uncle is high court judge, then their siblings and their nephew, niece are practicing lawyers. And eventually when time comes, they are fulfilling the criteria, then surpassing the meritocratic system. Sometimes this influence work. So don't you think that's a critical situation? We should think about, we should know about it, right? So that's why we are having this session. Now, so these are the points. Higher judiciary, it is applicable, appointment, transfer, and the fourth important point is independence of judiciary. So whenever we talk about collegium system, its debate has two ends. On one end is independence of judiciary, and on another end is transparency. And transparency in what? Transparency in transfer and appointment. Now the point is, when I use this word independence of judiciary, what comes to your mind? What do you know about this word, this phrase, independence of judiciary? Many of you might think that, oh, it's quite simple. Independence of judiciary means non-interference from legislature and executive, other pillars of government. That's what independence of judiciary is, right? But do you think that can be the only connotation, only meaning of independence of judiciary? Kya independence of judiciary ka keval itna matlab hai ki legislature and executive duri bana kar rakhe? If that's the only meaning, no, it is not. So let's dwell into this journey. This is how this lecture will flow. First, I'm going to talk about constitution mandates, means what constitution says. So when it comes to collegium system, so we have to know about what Article 124 says and what Article 217 says. Article 124 talk about Supreme Court, Article 217 talks about High Court. Then we are going to talk about three judges case. These are three cases which actually gave birth to this collegium system, because collegium system is not mentioned in our constitution. Okay, that's a point you should remember. Then we are going to talk about what is collegium system now, how is its composition. Then I'm going to talk about NJAC, National Judicial Appointment Commission. So recently, the Hindu published this infographic. Take a look. Patna High Court, 60.4% positions of judges are vacant. Take a look. Calcutta, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh. So all of you know the status of pendency of cases. People are waiting in the lines ki apna time aayega, kahin aur jane ka time aa jata, lekin जस्टिस मिलने का कई बार टाइम नहीं आ पाता, राइट? दैट्स अ क्रिटिकल सिचुएशन. अराउंड 419 वैकेंसीज आर देयर इन हाई कोर्ट जजेस, पोजिशन ऑफ हाई कोर्ट जजेस. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट मार्च 2021. ओके, एंड रिसेंटली सुप्रीम कोर्ट आस्क गवर्नमेंट दैट वी हैव गिवन यू 55 रिकमेंडेशंस. इट मींस कोलिजियम सिस्टम हैज गिवन यू 55 रिकमेंडेशंस एंड व्हाई नो अपॉइंटमेंट हैज बीन डन अंटिल नाउ. सो गवर्नमेंट इज गिविंग व्हाट द रीजंस आर, चेकिंग बैकग्राउंड एंड देयर आर सम पॉलिटिक्स इनसाइड. वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दिस पॉलिटिक्स एट सम अदर टाइम. लेट्स फोकस ऑन दिस कोलिजियम, what actually constitution says and how it evolved. So as per article 124, it says that president, actually supreme court judges are going to be appointed by president on consultation with CJI and such other supreme court and high court judges as president deem necessary. Okay, so it means one word here which is important is consulting with. और यहीं पर सारी की सारी डिबेट है कि कंसल्टेशन का मतलब क्या है. प्रेसिडेंट, कैन प्रेसिडेंट एक्चुअली रिजेक्ट दिस कंसल्टेशन इफ सीजीआई एंड सम जजेस से ओके सर, ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट प्लीज मेक दिस पर्सन एज जज ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट. सो दिस कंसल्टेशन इज इट मैंडेटरी और इट कैन बी साइडलाइन. सो फ्रॉम 1950 व्हेन आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वाज एनएक्टेड till 1973, everything was smooth. It means there was a kind of consensus. Whatever CJI and some judges recommended to president, and president also agreed on this. And let me tell you, when president is agreeing, president is not agreeing on his own will or on her own will. Actually, you should read this provision with Article 74. It means President has to act on aid and advice of Council of Minister. मतलब जो Council of Minister कहेंगे, for example, मोदी जी हमेशा कहेंगे सर बना दीजिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जज, ऑलरेडी कॉलेजियम ने रिकमेंड किया, हम भी कह रहे हैं कर दीजिए. President will ठीक है चलो कर दिया, right? Now the point is Council of Minister की advice, President, right? Now जब सब कुछ अच्छा चल रहा था till 1973, फिर 1973 में ऐसा क्या हुआ? So 1973 में हुआ केशव नंद भारती केस. आई एम गोइंग टू कम ओवर दिस. सेकेंड इज आर्टिकल 217. सो आर्टिकल 217 टॉक्स अबाउट अपॉइंटमेंट एंड ट्रांसफर ऑफ हाई कोर्ट जजेस. एंड फॉर दिस प्रेसिडेंट, यहां पर भी प्रेसिडेंट का रोल है. प्रेसिडेंट हैज टू टेक कंसल्टेशन विद अलोंग विद सीजेआई, गवर्नर एंड चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ दैट हाई कोर्ट. ओके, गवर्नर एंड चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ हाई कोर्ट. CJI is prominent. CJI is common. Whether you talk about Supreme Court judges, whether you talk about High Court judges, key person is Chief Justice of India. When it comes to High Court, you have to take recommendation from Governor and Chief Justice. This is what is written in Article 217. We are yet to come to this collegium system. Now, this is what Keshav Nand Bharti case I was talking about. So what happened in Keshav Nand Bharti case? केशव नंद भारती केस वॉज हैविंग 13 जजेस बेंच एंड आउट ऑफ दीज 13 जजेस 7 जजेस वर इन फेवर एंड 6 जजेस वर अगेंस्ट. इट मींस आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर डॉक्ट्रिन. सो सिंस 7 जजेस आर इन फेवर, सो दैट इज व्हाई वी गॉट बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर डॉक्ट्रिन एंड इट इज लाइक अ माइलस्टोन इंडिया इन इंडियाज constitutional political history, because this doctrine put a limit on legislature. Ki ek seema hai aapke paas, you cannot cross this Lakshman Rekha, otherwise we are going to declare that law null and void. And when government asks Supreme Court ki ye kya aapne bataya basic structure doctrine, and we cannot actually amend basic structure of constitution, but what is basic structure? It is not written in constitution. Then Supreme Court says, hum batayenge na, hum kyon hai Supreme Court? We are the ultimate interpreter. So now this tussle is started, right? Or who was the prime minister at this time? Indira Gandhi, Miss Indira Gandhi. These six judges were in favor of government, but these seven judges were not in favor of government. And when it comes to appointment of Chief Justice of India, there was a consensus, and still we have this consensus, that senior most judge of Supreme Court is appointed as CJI, senior most judge of Supreme Court. But Indira Gandhi ji ne soch liya tha ki acha government pe limit lagaoge, ilaaj to hum karenge. So kya kya unhone? So three senior most judges at that time were part of this seven judges. Okay, to Indira Gandhi ji ne kaha inko to banne nahi dena CJI. Kyon? Kyunki when it comes to CJI, he is also, or she is also appointed by president, and president act on alien rights of prime minister and his or her council of minister, right? So ultimately president to wo karega na jo prime minister chahega, right? Yahi hua. And this person, Mr. A. N. Ray, and he was appointed as CJI, surpassing three senior most judges, and it was the first time in India's, you know, judicial history or political history. And many writers at the time wrote that's a black day in Indian democracy. But and he was also questioned, he, why you actually accepted that position? You are a judge of Supreme Court, so you should have uphold the tradition of Supreme Court. Then Justice A.N. Ray said, I was only one of these six. Means there were other five. So अगर मैं एक्सेप्ट ना करता कोई और एक्सेप्ट कर लेता तो बेटर है कि मुझे मिल रहा था ऑफर ले लिया मैं, राइट नाउ. लेकिन यहां से क्वेश्चन स्टार्ट हो गया हमारी डेमोक्रेसी में कि हु हैज द फाइनल से ऑफ अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ जजेस, गवर्नमेंट और सुप्रीम कोर्ट? बिकॉज अर्लियर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू सीजीआई देयर वाज अ ट्रेडिशन, सीनियर मोस्ट जज विल बी अपॉइंटेड एज सीजीआई. व्हेन इट कम्स टू अदर सुप्रीम कोर्ट जजेस, this CJI, along with consultation with some judges, if or as president deems necessary, this recommendation used to be accepted, right? Now what is going to happen with this? Now who has the power? So to answer this question, we had this first judges case 1981, SP Gupta versus Union of India case. Ab yahan pe isi question pe baat ki gayi कि व्हेन इट कम्स टू आर्टिकल 124 सब क्लॉज 2, देयर इज दिस वर्ड कंसल्टेशन, मींस प्रेसिडेंट विल अपॉइंट जजेस ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट इन कंसल्टेशन विद चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ दिस क्वेश्चन वाज रेज्ड, दिस कंसल्टेशन इज बाइंडिंग और नॉट बाइंडिंग, और यू कैन से दैट द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस कंसल्टेशन इज कंकरेंस और नॉट, बिकॉज व्हेन इट कम्स टू कंकरेंस, कंकरेंस मींस ओके I have given you this recommendation and you have to concur. Okay. Now, this first judge's case actually twisted the dynamics in favor of who? Ye case kiske favor mein gaya hoga? Any guess? Supreme Court or government? Kiske favor mein gaya hoga? What's your guess? I have not told you. What's your guess? Actually, this went in favor of government. This case said that this consultation is not actually concurrence. It means if president has certain reason, important reasons, then president can say, okay, I am not accepting your advice. I am rejecting your advice. Okay. So actually this went in favor of union government. Aur ye 12 years tak yahi system chalta raha. 12 saal tak yahi chalta. And it was like court in first judge's case, Supreme Court has given this judgment against their own interest, right? It was like executive can reject the recommendation of Supreme Court and matlab CJI. Now, is pure prakaran mein, in the whole story, ek twist ho raha hai, right? Kyunki maza kaisa aayega bina twist ke? So, at that time, Union Law Minister, Mr. P. Shivshankar, what he did, he issued a circular. And the circular was given to state governments, governors, chief justices, and asked that tell us on two, give us list on 2 points. What were the 2 points? Number one, give us the names who have the qualification to become high court judges, which governor, chief minister and the CJ deems necessary. Ki haan haan, ye log ban sakte hain. Give us a list. And also tell us what are the three options where they would like to be appointed. Number one, this. Second was, some additional judges, means at high court level, union minister asked, tell us what is their priority in terms of transfers. So you can remember it like this. In this story, a union law minister actually was issuing circular on a point on which actually government never intervened. Government ko kya matlab isse? Ki kon ban sakta hai? कौन नहीं बन सकता है, वो गवर्नमेंट का काम नहीं है अभी. वो तो बात जो सीजीआई हैं, सीनियर जजेस हैं, दे वुड रिकमेंड एंड देन यू कैन एक्चुअली वेरीफाई द फाइल. ओके, ऑल रिकॉर्ड्स आर फाइन और नॉट, देयर इज अ पॉइंट ऑफ कंटेंशन और नॉट, दैट इज व्हाट द ड्यूटी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. हाउ इज गवर्नमेंट टेकिंग यू नो अ लिस्ट इन द फर्स्ट इंस्टेंस? इट इज लाइक एग्जीक्यूटिव इज इंटरवीनिंग. सो दिस वॉज द इंटरप्रिटेशन. तो इस पे तो ऐसा हो गया, इट वॉज लाइक कि now matter has came to a head. Ab to pani sar se upar chala. And at this point, when judiciary was saying ki it is belligerent in, you know, interjection in our territory, you cannot do that, it is against our independence. But at this point, Mr. P. Shivshankar, he said that ki when it comes to independence of judiciary, does it mean touch me not, ki koi chhu nahi sakta aapko? He said, I have not issued circular for appointing someone because I am not having that power. That power resides with Honorable President. And consultation process is there. As mentioned in Article 124 for Supreme Court, this is 217 for High Court judges. I am just asking this so that we can bring a system where these judges can be transferred frequently across the country. And we can bring a sense of unity and integrity. Many judges are in the same high court for a quite longer time, and this should not happen. So that was the point which Mr. P. Shivshankar raised that point. Now came the second judge's case. So in first judge's case, what happened? It went in favor of government. Kaha ki president can actually reject also your recommendation, right? Now twist, actually, you know, things twisted in second judge's case. Aur yahan par kya hua? Yahan par hua birth of collegium. So our topic is collegium, and it was born in second judge's case, you should remember. And this case is also remembered with SCARA, means Supreme Court Advocate on Record versus Union of India case. So in this case, finally Supreme Court said that there will be a collegium. Collegium means advisory board, in which there will be one CJI, means Chief Justice of India, and two senior most judges. And they will give recommendation to president. They will give recommendation to president. And now president has to act on the advice of this collegium. Means now this consultation is not ki tum reject kar doge. No, now this consultation is determinative in nature. Right, you have to give primacy to this consultation, means whatever consultation is given, you have to appoint that person. One clause was that you can actually send back this recommendation for reconsideration for once. If this similar file has come again, then you have to, you know, appoint that person as Supreme Court judge. But the point is, yahan par kisi timeline ki baat nahi ki gayi. It means if collegium has recommended name of Shashank Tyagi, okay, Soshte, that please appoint Shashank Tyagi as judge of Supreme Court under this category, third category, eminent jurist. Okay, now the point is, collegium has recommended. Now government of the time, they saw some of my articles who were against their policies, and they said no. They send back the file to collegium ki please recommend, you know, reconsider this name, we are not agreeing to that. But CJI and collegium, they were in my favor. एंड दे अगेन सेड नो, हम तो इसी बंदे को चाहते हैं, वी वॉन्ट दिस पर्सन टू बी यू नो जज ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट. नाउ कैन प्रेजिडेंट ऑन द एडवाइस ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टर काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर कैन रिजेक्ट माई फाइल? नो, दे कैन नॉट रिजेक्ट माई फाइल, बट दे हैव यू नो दे हैव दिस लेवरेज, दे कैन सिट ऑन माई फाइल. एंड दैट इज वॉट गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग on many files, and that is why we started this session from this, you know, this news in which Supreme Court asked, why 55 recommendations, you have not done anything. So they can sit on my file and they can wait ki age pass kar jane do, right? Because all of you know that if you cross this particular criteria, for example, for Supreme Court judge, maximum age is 65 years. So if I cross the age of 65 years, then that file won't be of any use. So their loophole is time is not given, right? But second judge case said determinative, manna padega, reject nahi kar sakte, right? Now came the third judge's case. Ab jab second judge case mein collegium system aa gaya tha, but third judge case ki zarurat kya thi? We should actually learn polity like this. Okay, I always say that in polity you should strengthen your three pillars: principles, provisions, interpretation. So what we are doing here, first we've started with principles, that independence of judiciary. What is independence of judiciary? Why we need collegium? Provision, then we talked about provisions, article 124, article 217, what article 74 says, that president has to act on identity rights of council of minister. Then interpretation, what is we are doing as of now? Interpretation, that in third judge case, I argue, get to the reason. Reason was, it was asked, when you said consultation is primacy, means you have to act on the advice of collegium. But president himself asked this question to Supreme Court using article 143. And president was Mr. K.R. Narayanan. So he asked Supreme Court using article 143, president can seek advice. When you say that I have to act on advice of CJI collegium, now this advice is given only by CJI, or CJI is actually bound to consult with other judges? Means consultation ka matlab kya hai? Means consultation ka matlab consultation with other number of judges hai ki nahi, or whether sole opinion of CJI is enough? That was the issue which was raised by Mr. K.R. Narayanan, and very valid issue, right? Kyunki beech mein aisa ho raha tha, whatever CJI recommends, CJI would say, no, I am the CJI, I am the head of this collegium. I say that, that's why it will be considered that this is the advice of collegium. K.R. Narayanan said, no, just be clear at this point. So at this point, what Supreme Court said? Supreme Court said, Honorable President, your issue is very, very valid. So actually, if even two judges are giving adverse opinion, okay, consider that there's one student, Rohit, and Rohit wanted to become Supreme Court judge, right? And on when his name crop up in collegium, so when it comes to third judge's case, third judge's case says that one CJI and four Supreme Court judges, okay? So it means total five. Now third judge's case says that if even two judges are against the name of Rohit, then CJI cannot give this recommendation to Honorable President. Okay, so agar CJI ka bilkul khasam khas hai Mr. Rohit, tab bhi CJI cannot do this. So now this is the criteria. Okay, CJI, four senior most judges in Supreme Court. Now the point is, अब कमी क्या है कॉलेजियम में? What are the drawbacks? Number one drawback is what I told you, uncle judge syndrome, right? Nepotism, allegations are raised many times. Opaqueness, this is not clear कि why you are recommending Shashank and rejecting Rohit. It may be possible that Rohit has given landmark judgments during his time in High Court, and now you're not selecting, you know, recommending Rohit's name. Why? So there is no objective criteria. Okay, so it may be possible the judges act on whims and fancies. So that is why I say nepotism is there, right? And that is why we are having public controversy. And do you think that we should entertain and allow public controversies for an institution as important as judiciary. Judiciary is responsible for upholding justice in our country. So we should not have any scope of this level. We should think, if there is a case that there is opaqueness, then we should look how we can bring transparency, and transparency along with ensuring independence of judiciary. That should be our focus area, because it overlooks many talented, you know, judges and advocates. So this was a major issue. And for this, what government did? Like I am saying, we should talk about some solutions. So government, you know, finally had this NJC using 1990th Amendment Act. But what happened? NJC hai kya? National Judicial Appointment Commission. Government said, we are actually amending constitution, and Supreme Court is what? Interpreter of constitution. If constitution itself will say that there will be NJAC in place of collegium, means collegium to naam hi nahi hai, constitution NJAC naam hai, to uske hisab se chalna hoga. Means if NJAC is there in constitution, then government has, then the Supreme Court has to, you know, interpret the process of appointment and transfer along with what is written in this amendment. But what Supreme Court said? Supreme Court said, okay, you are a parliament, so you have power to amend constitution, but I am Supreme Court. If anything is against the basic structure of constitution, then I can declare it null and void. Sarkar ne kai baar pucha, many times government asks, what is this basic structure? Give us a list now. Then we can actually surpass it. We can think, okay, this is what, we cannot do amendment, otherwise we can do amendment. Supreme Court said, no, there is no such list. We are going to decide what is basic structure on case to case basis. And this is what Supreme Court did that. In this case, Supreme Court said NJAC against independence of judiciary. And independence of judiciary is basic structure of constitution. And that is why we are rejecting it. So it was declared null and void. So ye aaya to sahi, lekin kuch hua nahi iska. Phir bhi hum jaan lete hain tha kya. So NJAC mein there would be a CJI as chairperson. Okay, collegium ko change karne ki baat ki gayi thi. There was an effort to change the collegium system, but this could not become successful. Two other senior judges of Supreme Court, okay, so Union Minister of Law, then two persons nominated, means those who are of eminence from the field of, you know, judiciary, and they would have been appointed by Prime Minister, CJI, and leader of opposition of the House. But the point is, this could not be materialized. Supreme Court declared this null and void. Although that was a step for bringing transparency. Okay, on this point, I would like to quote Mr. A.P. Shah, ex-justice Mr. A.P. Shah. So he said he was in favor of, you know, declaring this NJAC null and void. But at the same point, he asked judiciary to reconsider the present setup of collegium system and take steps to bring transparency by actually uploading the reasons why you are actually selecting one and rejecting other on their website. So it will actually bring back the confidence which many people loses by questioning on this opaqueness. I hope you got this clarity on this collegium and on the journey. Let's meet in some other video. Till then, keep smiling, keep growing. Shashank Tyagi, signing off.